Now we will discuss driven RLC circuit. Okay, so far we have seen source free parallel and series RLC network. Now we will see driven series and parallel RLC network. So in driven RLC network, RLC circuit, complete response is equal to natural response plus force response. How we calculated in RL and driven RL and driven RC network, there we have seen that it will have two parts, one is natural response, another one is force response. So once we add those two, we will get the complete response. Okay, same method we will follow here also. So we'll take start with an example. Okay, determine the expression for VC of t in the following circuit. Circuit is given here. So it has two current source, one is 4 u of t. So that means this source will be active only when t is greater than 0. Before that, this source will be inactive. Inactive means this current source amplitude will be 0. And one more current source we have, that is 5 ampere. Okay, and current passing through inductor is IL, voltage across capacitor is VC. Okay. So for this we have to get an expression for VC of t, the complete response it is. Okay, so we will start with our circuit, equivalent circuit at t less than 0. To less than 0, this 4 ampere, this current source is inactive. So our equivalent circuit will be, so we have a capacitor and current source, so this value is 1/27, this is 30, this is 3, and current passing through this IL and voltage across this is VC and 5. Okay, similarly for t greater than 0, that time both this 4 ampere and 5 ampere, both current source will be active. So we will write first 4 ampere and and 5 ampere. So this is 5 and 1/27, 30, 3, current passing through this IL, voltage across this is VC. Okay, so this is about the equivalent circuit for t less than 0, greater than 0. Okay, now step 1, first we have to determine whether it is series RLC or parallel RLC. So that one we have to identify. So you take to consider this circuit for d greater than 0, consider this t greater than 0 circuit. In that, you deactivate all the independent sources. You consider circuit t greater than 0 and deactivate all the independent sources. We have two independent sources here, one is 5 ampere, another one is 4 ampere. If you deactivate these two, remaining circuit is what? So if you deactivate this one and this one, what do you mean by deactivate? Deactivate means current source amplitude will be 0. When it is 0, it is open circuit. For a voltage source, it should be a deactivate means it is a short circuit. Okay. So if you remove these two current source, remaining circuit is RLC, which are in series. So it is a series RLC network. Okay. So series RLC network. So that one we will first write. This is series RLC network and it is a driven RLC because t greater than 0 also we have active independent sources. Okay, so that's why it is a series RLC network and driven. So we will see alpha now. Alpha, if you calculate, it is R/2L. And R/2L, if you substitute, it is 3/6, and that is nothing but 5. Okay. omega naught is 1 by root LC. If you substitute, you will get 3. Okay, so alpha and omega naught we have calculated, and if we compare that alpha and omega naught, alpha is greater than omega naught. Alpha is greater than omega naught. Okay, so since it is greater than omega naught, so that means it is overdamped response. Overdamped response. Okay. So in overdamped response, what is the form of the solution? Form of the solution will be Vc of t will be Vf, that means force response, Vcf plus Vcn, Vcn. Okay. And Vcn, this is the natural response, that will be a1 e power s1 t plus a2 e power s2 t. Okay. So here we have to find s1 and s2. So directly we can calculate s1 is minus alpha plus under the square root of alpha square minus omega naught square, and s2 is minus alpha minus under the square root alpha square minus omega naught square. Okay. So if you calculate this one, s1 will be minus 1, s1 will be minus 1 and s2 will be minus 9. Okay. So these two values you will get. So okay, that is the step 1. Step 2, so step 2, in the step 2 we have to find initial current and initial voltage. So let us first find IL of 0 minus. Let us see the circuit that at t equal to 0 minus. So at t equal to 0 minus, this inductor will be acting like a short and this capacitor will be acting like an open circuit. So remaining part in the circuit is a 5 ampere current source and 30 ohm resistance. So we want to find current flowing through the 30 ohm resistor is nothing but current flowing through the inductor. The capacitor will be open circuit. So what is the current flowing through this inductor? It is 5 ampere. So it's easy. This is 5 ampere. Now Vc of 0 minus we have to calculate. So Vc of 0 minus, you can see here this at t equal to 0 minus capacitor will be open circuit. This will be short circuit. So if you can find out the voltage across 30 ohm resistor, voltage across 30 ohm resistor, that will be nothing but the Vc of 0 minus. So what is the current flowing through this 30 ohm? That is 5. So 5 into 30, 150 volt. So 150 volt is the 150 volt is the Vc of 0 minus or open circuit voltage. Now once we know these two, I can directly find IL of 0 plus is nothing but IL of 0 minus, that is equal to 5 ampere. And Vc of 0 plus is equal to Vc of 0 minus, that is equal to 150 volt. Okay. So we have calculated the initial condition. Now step 3. Step 3, we have to find this Vc is nothing but Vcf plus Vcn. So in that, this Vcf, that is the force response, we have to calculate. What is the forced response of this circuit? This force response or Vc of infinity, this also called, it is also called Vc of infinity. At t equal to infinity, what is the voltage across capacitor? That we have to calculate. So in this circuit, at t equal to 0, this is the circuit. At t equal to infinity, this capacitor will be, this capacitor will act like an open circuit. So what is the voltage across these two? So I think better I will copy this circuit and try it once again there. So if you, so if you copy and paste this circuit here, So here, which one at t equal to infinity, this act like a short. So I have to change this to short. This will act like a short, and this will act like a open circuit. So this will be open. So if you, this will be open. Now we are finding the voltage across this. We are finding voltage across this capacitor. Okay. Since this is short, all the 4 ampere, this 4 ampere current flows through this only. This 4 ampere current will not come this side. All current will flow through this short circuit. So 4 ampere will pass through this one. So this part of the circuit essentially is cut off. Now what is the remaining 5 ampere current source you have, 30 ohm resistor you have, and you have a short circuit. So current flows through like this, 5 ampere current will flow through like this. So you want to find voltage across the capacitor, it is nothing but voltage across this resistor, that is nothing but 5 into 30. So Vc of infinity, or it is also called Vcf, force response, that is nothing but 5 into 30, that is 150 volt. So we know now Vc of infinity or Vc of f is 150, okay, that is step 3. Step 4, we have to find Vcn. So since it is overdamped response, it will have this form, a1 into e power s1t plus a2 e power s2t. This is Vcn. Remember, this is Vcn, that is the natural response. So for that we have to first write complete response, that is Vcf plus a1 e power s1t plus a2 e power s2t. In this we have to substitute Vc of 0. We calculated before Vc of 0, here it is, Vc of 0 is 150. So that you substitute here, that is 150 equal to Vcf, Vcf also we have calculated, it is 150, and t if you substitute to 0, this will be plus a1 plus a2. So we can directly write a1 plus a2 is nothing but 0. This is equation number 1, equation number 1. Now step 5, we have to find the another equation which relates a1 and a2. So if you differentiate this equation with respect to time, so you will get dvc by dt, and we know that dvc by dt, where t is equal to 0, if you substitute the resulting equation, whatever you get, that will be equal to Ic of 0 plus divided by C. Okay. So we know that dVc by dt, t 0 plus is nothing but Ic of 0 plus divided by C. We can easily calculate Ic of 0 plus since we know IL of 0 plus. Okay. So this is nothing but you have to differentiate this one, this will be a1 s1, here you have to differentiate with respect to t. So Vcf is a constant, if you differentiate it is 0, this is a1 s1, a2 s2, and t equal to 0 there. Okay, a1 s2 s1 plus a2 s2 equal to Ic of 0 plus divided by c, divided by c. Okay, so what is a1? A1 and a2 we have to calculate. S1 and s2 we know that. What is that S1, S2? Let me see. Minus 1, minus 9. Okay. So we'll write that one. Minus a1 minus 9 a2 equal to Ic of 0 plus divided by C. Now we have to calculate Ic of 0 plus. This one we have to calculate now. Okay. So for that, let me take again that circuit. This circuit. This circuit we will, okay. So in this, at t equal to 0 plus, we will write. What happens at t equal to 0 plus? T equal to 0 plus, we have to replace inductor by short circuit and capacitor by voltage source. This should be inductor replaced by current source, and this should be replaced by voltage source. Okay, and we can write this one. This is a current source at t equal to 0 plus only, then its value we have calculated IL of 0. Let me see that IL of 0 minus is 5 amp. So IL of 0 plus also 5 ampere. So this current is 5 ampere. And we have a voltage source here, that is not voltage source, it is a capacitor, but at t equal to 0 plus it can be modeled as a voltage source with voltage 150. And we will write, this is IL, current passing through this one is IL, that is 5 ampere, and we will write this one as IR of 0 plus, and current passing through this, actually it is a capacitor, this is nothing but IC of 0 plus. Okay, so that we are interested, and IL of 0 plus is here, that is 5. Okay, so we have three currents, IL of 0 plus flowing through this, that is 5 ampere, IR of 0 plus that is flowing through like this, that is through resistance, and IC of 0 plus that is flowing through this side. So that is nothing but the passing through the capacitor. Okay, so now what we will do, first we will apply KVL at this node, KCL. If you apply KCL this node, this is nothing but 4 plus IR of 0 plus equal to 5. So IR of 0 plus is nothing but 1 ampere. Similarly, one more KCL we apply at this node. So that is nothing but 5 equal to IC of 0 plus plus IR of 0 plus. IR of 0 plus we know it is 1. So IC of 0 plus is nothing but 4 ampere. Okay. So in this equation we will substitute, that is minus A1 minus 9 A2, minus A1 minus 9 A2 equal to IC of 0 plus, that is 4, capacitance 1 by 27. If you substitute that one, that will be 108. Okay. So now you have two equations. This is equation 2, minus A1 minus 9 A2 equal to 108, and one more equation you have, A1 plus A2 equal to 0. So if you solve this one, solving you will get A1 13.5 and A2 minus 13.5 you will get. So complete response of VC of t, that is equal to VCF plus VCN. In that VCF we know it is 150, and VCN A1 is 13.5 e power S1 t, S1 is minus 1, and minus A2 into e power S2 t is minus 90. So this is the complete response. Okay.